10% reduction, that's what you want. We'll give it to the Facebook fund to deliver to food banks or to anybody else. It's a charity. Show that you mean it.
Agreed. Agreed. Thank you for that. Item 11, political proportions on the committee. Mayor Anderson. Can I remind members that the indicators in the report in the agenda in order to suspend a personality, but the committee's list as all members presented must vote in favour with no dissentients voting, this being complied with the requirements of Section 17(1)(b), Local Government and Housing Act 1989. If there are any members dissenting, then proportionately rules are applied to those committees. Mary.
Can I move that the political proportions on committees and the allocation of seats, as set out in Appendix 5 attached to this note, be approved? The proposed appointments of chairs of committees, as circulated, be approved. The deputy chairs of committees be appointed at the first meeting of each committee and reported to the next meeting of the City Council, and for any seats not yet allocated to members, the names of proposed committee members or alternates designated by groups may be reported to the City Solicitor in writing and which will have immediate effect once received.
Speak to the motion which we are supporting. I think it actually is useful to say honestly and honourably, this administration has done what other administrations haven't done. It's actually given the opposition parties a higher proportion to committee places to ensure scrutiny takes place, and opposition parties, if they talk to each other, and that is a myth, can actually move amendments to committees. So I think that does need saying. And I think the other thing I'd like to say, I was pleased that our Liberal Party group volunteered without any compunction to keep what I think is a very important principle, and I noticed the Greens also supported, that whilst an independent member is not entitled legally to committee place, we both believed that it was an important principle of equal and individual representation. Independent councillors were given an opportunity to participate in the council on an equal footing, and therefore we both took steps to facilitate Councillor Prendergast, the former leader of this council, having committee places as well. And I think those two things are worthwhile saying, because that hasn't always been the case, certainly under a previous administration, where there was very much a pick and mix about people's rights to represent their constituents.
For that. Is that agreed? Thank you. Item 12, selected committee structure and terms of reference, Councillor Mary Rasmussen.
Can I move that in respect of the appointment of select committees, the following 8 select committees be established for the municipal year 2018 to 2019. Audit and Governance Select, Culture, Tourism and Events Select, Education and Children's Services Select, Employment and Skills Select, Neighbourhood Select, Regeneration and Sustainability Select, Social Care and Health Select, and Housing Select. That with regard to the establishment of a Housing Select Committee, the terms of reference, names of members, and the date of the committee, this be submitted for consideration to the council meeting on the 19th of September 2018, and that the terms of reference for each of the select committees as set out on pages 172 to 186 on the agenda be approved.
That agreed? No? Okay,
so. Madam Lord Mayor, just ask for clarification. Whilst the terms of reference for the Housing Committee hasn't been tabled, am I correct? I thought the membership had been tabled, I just wanted clarification. But also, can I say, the Liberal Party group did oppose when the council abolished the housing committee. We've expressed that to you several times. I'm absolutely delighted such a major activity of the council is being restored. Thank you, my Lord Mayor.
Mayor, I just look.
Lord Mayor, it's not one cynical or any issue other than we've now put in place the housing company. We're now appointing some staff, and we are also in the process of doing some issues around putting together a programme of work, and also some publicity stuff around the sites and where we're going, what tenure and what we're offering. All that's been put in place, and then we will have that discussed and debated and stuff at the first select committee. So it's not sinister in that way. But I agree with you. You know, the fact of the matter is that, of course, the administration that sold off all the council houses and left parts of the city like a war zone and stuff, we could and should have had a select committee, and I believe that it's the right thing to do, because we are now setting up a new housing company that I think the city can be proud of and excited by what our offer will be. So it will be up and running in September, and the nominations and the numbers for the select committee will be offered up to the groups. Can I respond? Yes, they have, but if given the new changes, and what if anybody wants to change that, but it won't be in operation until September.
Councillor Kemp.
Thank you, my Lord Mayor. You'll see on the final page of the note our amendment. We're now revising that, because we didn't know until we got here that the Housing Select Committee had, was actually doing a review of its functions. So we'll withdraw that bit which relates to the Housing Select Committee, but would ask when the report comes back that these items be considered. I would just say, though, that I definitely am not fat, but I have a good memory as well. And I remember which party it was in 1995 that first suggested that we dispose of all our stock by way of a stock transfer. And that motion, out of the blue, was moved by Councillor Peter Coventry, the Labour Chair of the Housing Committee, and that the Labour Party voted for every single stock transfer. But let me deal well with the two remaining items on this amendment. The first relates to... I'm pleased to say... even my backbenchers want to speak on this issue, just to show we can take this out of myself. The first relates to the Audit and Governance Select Committee. And I must say that I thought the speech given by the Mayor before about his accessibility and availability was a total work of fiction. Perhaps that can best be seen, actually, by the ruling that you quite rightly gave. When he gave us a lot of stuff about chief executive and what have you, you're quite right. I am not allowed to raise questions in this council on a statement made by the mayor. That's how accessible the mayor is. When we put a question to him in council, it is committed in writing. And no matter what load of old rubbish he puts down as a reply, which is usually an attack on something that I did 32 years ago, we have no opportunity at all to ask him a supplementary question. My colleague, Councillor Makinson, will deal with some of these issues. But at one time, my Lord Mayor, we had a mayoral select committee, and we had an overview and scrutiny select committee, which wasn't just composed of the chairs, which at the moment are all Labour, but on which there was all party representation. And there are two things about that. First of all, that gave us the opportunity regularly to question the mayor in a select committee as part of his programme, and we believe that we should see that again. And the second, it brought to that committee, and I remember well, Baroness Morris telling us how we needed to benchmark our work against other cities benchmarks against the core cities. Now, perhaps that will be in the recommendations that the mayor has brought, will be bringing forward. But at the moment, we don't know what those recommendations are. So we specifically want to see the fact that Liverpool is benchmarked not against its own past, but against the other core cities with whom we compete, but are certainly a good guide.
So are we going to put your amendment through or not?
Well, I'm doing. And then the last one is relating to regeneration as.